The Lerdge 3D printer drives the X-axis and Y-axis sliders to move through the belt. The tightness of the belt directly determines the accuracy of sliders' movement. Too loose of the belt can cause inability to deliver precise motion, leading to strange textures or the loss of details on the surface of the print model. Too tight of the belt will increase the reversing resistance of motor, leading to reverse step loss and the wrong layer of prints. So, we have designed the tension adjustment knob for both X and Y axis belts. Next, we will demonstrate the method of adjusting the tension of the belt. Firstly, raise X axis cantilever for viewing in video. This is the tension adjustment knob for X axis belt. Rotate clockwise to tighten the belt and rotate counterclockwise to loosen the belt. Firstly, release the X-axis belt. At this point, the X-axis belt is in a slack state. Then observe the connection between the belt and the slider. Look at this position and that position. Slowly turn the knob to tighten the belt. The belt changes from loose to straight in the video. At this point, move the X-axis slider left and right by hand. Observe the state of belt at the connection between the belt and the slider. Right there and right there. You can see that the belt jumps up and down when moving the slider from side to side. Continue to adjust the belt until the belt no longer jumps up and down when move the slider left and right. There is still some slight jumping in this place. Continue tightening the belt, observe, and adjust. When adjusting the tension of the X-axis belt, make small adjustments as many times as possible. Alright, so far move the slider slightly left and right. The connection between belt and slider is no longer jumping up and down. The tightness adjustment of the X-axis belt is completed. Now you can see that the belt is not as tight as expected. If you press it by hand, it can still produce some distortion. But when the slider moves from side to side, the belt will no longer jump up and down. It should be noted that the belt is not as tight as possible. Too tight belt may cause this fixed block to be broken. First of all, this is the Y-axis, and this is the tension adjustment knob of the Y-axis belt. Turn counterclockwise to loosen the belt. In order to demonstrate more intuitively, let's remove the heat bed. You don't have to remove the heat bed when you operate. This is the Y-axis slider. If your belt grows out, you can cut it. But don't cut it too short, keep it to a certain length. Loosen this belt on the Y-axis. Now the Y-belt is in a relaxed state. Observe the connection between the belt and the slider. It is about this position. And this position at the second half. Move this slider back and forth on the Y-axis. The belt connection will be pulled up and down for a while. It's jumping up and down. Including the same position in the back, the connection between the belt and the slider jump up and down. Look at the front and back belts. turn the knob counterclockwise to tighten the belt. Do not rotate the angle too much each time. Rotate about 30 degrees, or 3 or 4 teeth on the adjustment knob. Adjust several times and observe until the connection between the belt and the Y-axis slider no longer jumps up and down. The connection between the belt and the slider is no longer jumping up and down. So now the tension of the Y-axis slider belt has been adjusted to an appropriate state. You can see that the belt is not too tight to press by hand now. The Y-axis slider is pulling this big hotbed, and the prince is also on the hotbed. When Y-axis slider reverses, it has a greater reversing inertia. So we suggest tightening the Y-axis belt a little more. That is, rotate two more teeth in the appropriate state of adjustment. For example, let's take this tooth right here and then rotate two more teeth. Then it is to turn the tooth to the current position. Okay, so we put the belt in a slightly tighter position. The adjustment of the Y-axis belt is completed. Same as the X-axis, the belt is not meant to be rotated as tight as possible. If you rotate it too tight, the Y-axis motor will be overloaded. This may lead to motor loss steps or other problems during the printing process. So it's not as tight as possible. It's fitting. Okay, after the adjustment is finished, we'll put the hotbed back in again. You do not have to remove the hotbed when you adjust the tension of the belt.